Hey guys, today we're going to try to train this little guy to find the best path across the frozen lake. If you haven't installed this reinforcement learning library, do pip install gymnasium. If you need more help installing, check out my install guide. The link is in the description. Let's start with the basic code to launch the frozen lake environment. Let me execute this. All right, I put a breakpoint here so the guy stops moving. Let's go over the code. Up here, I imported the gymnasium library. I'm declaring a instance of the frozen lake environment. I'm using the 8x8 map. I'm turning on the slippery flag. We'll talk about what that means in a sec. And then I'm turning on rendering so we can actually see the map here. We're calling reset here to reset the guy up to the initial position. The reset function returns two parameters. We're just interested in the first one, which is the state. The state goes from 0 to 63. 0 on the top left, and then 1, 2, and so on, and then 63 at the bottom. There are two conditions that ends the simulation. Terminated becomes true if the little guy falls into any of these holes, or if it actually reaches the goal. And then truncated, if the guy wanders around for more than 200 steps, the simulation also ends. So we do a while loop while those two conditions are not true. We select a random action. The available set of actions are 0 to represent left, 1 is down, 2 is right, 3 is up. After selecting the action, we'll execute the action, return the new state, a reward if there's any, and the two simulation ending conditions. So let's say the selected action is right, so it's going to go this way. It's going to go from state 0 to state 1. So the new state is 1. The way the reward structure works is that the little guy gets a reward of 1 when it reaches the goal. Otherwise, there are no rewards or penalties anywhere else. Now that we have a new state, we're going to assign it to the current state and keep looping until one of these conditions are true. And then we're going to close the environment. Now let's talk about the slippery flag. The slippery flag actually makes it so the step function doesn't always honor the chosen action. So here's an example. Let's say the guy is here. If the chosen action is to go this way, there's actually a chance that he's gonna slip up or slip down. If he's here and he wants to go down, there's a chance that he's gonna slip sideways. This actually makes the scenario much more interesting because you can't really solve this using a traditional pathfinding algorithm. Lastly, if you're wondering what happens if the guy tries to go off map, he'll just stay in the same spot. Okay, now we're ready to talk about Q-Learning. Let's start with the end result that we're looking for. In Q-Learning, we're looking to construct a lookup table. So in this case, we have 64 states by 4 actions. So we're going to have a 64 by 4 array. We're going to use the Q-Learning formula to calculate values for each one of these combinations. After training, the table should be complete. Here's an example of how the Q-table is going to be used after training. So let's say we're in state 62. Say 62 is right here. Let's say the Q-values look like this. So when we're in this state, the AI is going to come to the table, find state 62, find the biggest Q-value. So it's going to go right. Let's initialize the Q table. We need to import NumPy. Use NumPy to initialize a 64 by 4 array with all zeros. The Q learning formula depends on two parameters. In future videos, we'll talk about how these two parameters affect the formula. For now, we'll just use the numbers that work for me. Now I'll put in the Q-learning formula after taking a step. The formula updates the current state action pair with the reward that it received for taking the step and also the largest Q value in the new state. Right now the simulation ends after one try. We need to enclose this code inside a for loop. Episodes is the number of times we're going to train. We'll pass this in through the function. Right now we're selecting actions randomly. But over time, we should start following the path dictated by the Q table. To do that, we'll implement the Epsilon-Greedy policy. So I'm going to add three new variables. One is Epsilon. When Epsilon is 1, it means we're picking 100% random actions. Over time, we're going to decrease the randomness. We'll use the Epsilon decay rate to do that. Here, I'm just declaring a random number generator. If the number that we generate is less than epsilon, we'll take the random action. Otherwise, we'll follow the Q table. After each episode, we're going to decrease epsilon all the way until it gets to zero. The epsilon decay rate is another parameter that we can adjust. Again, we'll talk about how to tune these numbers in the future. This number actually has a direct impact on how many episodes or the minimum number of episodes that I need to train. So right now I have it set to 0.0001. If I want epsilon to get to zero, I'm going to need to train for 10,000 episodes because I'm subtracting this number from one after each episode. So it's going to take 10,000 episodes to get one all the way down to zero. So let's go ahead and train maybe 15,000 episodes. And finally, I want to reduce the learning rate. This helps stabilize the Q values after we're no longer exploring. We're pretty much ready to start training, but let me add some code to help with tracking how the training progresses. We'll keep track of whether we collected rewards for an episode or not, and then add this code to get it on a graph. The graph is going to show a running sum of the rewards for every 100 episodes. We need to import the graphing library. And let's control the rendering to the function. We'll set the render mode to human if the render flag is true. Otherwise, we'll set it to not render. Before we start training, I found a problem here. Make sure the epsilon adjustments and all this is within the for loop. And also rewards per episode. This needs to be initialized outside the for loop. After the training, I want to save the Q table to a file so that I can reload it and use it again. I'm going to use the pickle library to save the file. For the first training, I'm going to turn off the slippery flag just to keep things simpler. Okay, we're ready to train. I'm going to hit F5. It's running right now. Okay, it's been a minute and training is done. Let's check out the files. The x-axis is the number of episodes, so from 0 to 15,000. The y-axis is the number of rewards per 100 episodes. We can see from the beginning where it's 100% exploration rate, the amount of rewards collected per 100 episodes is almost non-existent. As epsilon decreases to about 50%, near 5,000, the little guy is using more and more of the Q table, so you can see that the number of rewards is increasing. From about 5,000 to 10,000, we see a significant increase in the amount of reward collected. At 10,000 episodes, epsilon is zero, so there is no more exploration. The little guy is following the Q table 100% of the time. Since the slippery flag is off, when he follows the Q table, he's going to get to the goal 100% of the time. So you can see that from 10,000 to 15,000, it's 100% reward. The Q values are saved to this file. Since it's a binary file, we won't really be able to read it. What we can do is modify the code. So we load the Q table from file and then see how it performs. I'm going to add some code to distinguish whether we're training or whether we're using a trained model. Let's add a isTraining flag. If we're training, then initialize the Q table. Otherwise, we'll load the model back into the Q variable. If we're training, then we do the random steps. Otherwise, we'll look up the Q table. And then only update the Q table if we're training. And only save the Q table if we're training. Okay, now we can run the model. Let's run it for 1,000 times. Set is training to false, F5, and it's done. Let's check out the image. Since we're doing a running sum of 100, from 0 to 100 is going to look like an increasing line, so this is fine. And then we can see that all 1,000 episodes is getting 100% reward. Now let's turn on rendering and see what the guy is actually doing. I'll just do it one time. Okay, now let's do the training again with the slippery factor on. Same thing, 15,000. And turn this back on. And F5. Okay, it's done. Let's check out the image. With the slippery factor on, we can see that the first almost 7,000 to 8,000 episodes are barely getting any rewards. Then as it starts following the Q table more often, it's just collecting okay amount of rewards. And finally at 10,000, where we're following the Q table exclusively, we're getting about between 60 to 85 reward. Now let's try the model. We'll do it one time to see what it looks like. You can see with the slippery flag on, he's doing a whole lot more back and forth. Let's see how it does in 1,000 episodes. Okay, let's check out the image. Looks like in actual tests, the model is not as great. It's hovering between maybe 40 to 60%. So the slippery factor really makes things a lot more difficult. If I rerun the training, the results are more in line with the testing. I think the first time where I got pretty high rewards, that's probably luck. There's also instances where the little guy never reached the goal in all 15,000 episodes, so it never trained. So a better model could be had by adjusting the amount of episodes and all those other parameters that can be adjusted. It's a trade-off between time and am I happy with the results that I have right now. In the future, we can talk about how to make this better. I think we're good for now. Thanks for following along.